we're back, you know, for our music special on concert ticket prices. And in studio, we have with us Wee Teck from the New Paper, Sheila from Tabla, and Suzanne from Radio 913. Actually, do you know what's the most expensive concert ever in Singapore?
Rain.
Wrong. It has to be. No, it wasn't
it? Was it Chinese or English one? Chinese or
English?
English, yeah. Yes. Air Supply.
Wrong.
Rolling Stone.
Okay, never mind. I will give the answer.
Okay. She said she will give the answer, sir.
I think I know.
Tina Turner.
Wrong.
Tina Turner.
Mariah Carey.
Wrong.
Oh, okay, I'll give up.
Then I will give the answer.
Give the answer already.
The police.
Huh? How much was that?
Okay,
$100.
But
wow, but then again,
that's another iconic group.
That's an iconic group. Yeah, the police.
I think it's coming back, you know, next month. And also commanding $600.
I don't know. He's playing classical music.
I can't buy Sting because he sold out. He was cool with the police. And then when he did, like, walking on what this... Love on the Seventh Wave. That's when he kind of sold out to all the suits and the bankers. So, I mean, I won't watch Sting.
The thing is,
I mean, he became very corporate.
With the police, I can understand.
Yeah.
The iconic band, they broke up. Mm. Their reunion was so talked about, so anticipated.
Mm.
You know, it is the stuff.
But
that,
people
you know,
have gone their music wrong. Do you know Every Breath You Take is a stalker song? I mean, it gives me the creeps. I don't know why everyone thinks it's a great love song. The guy is stalking.
Yeah, it's an angry
whoever
song.
He's got
despite that, it's an iconic song.
Yeah, okay, yeah, it won awards.
Stalkers out there, please do not use that as your theme music.
So I know it's like Every Breath You Take. Everyone's waiting for that song, right? But for me, why would I pay $600 to hear that song that gives me the creeps?
Okay, cool. Well, you know, Rain, like you mentioned just now, when news was first, you know, released that he's going to have a concert, they said it would be $888.
That's a lot of money.
That's a ripoff.
Yeah.
So what was it eventually?
Eventually, $488.
So expensive. How are kids going to watch it? That's for me, that's it as a DJ, right? Oh. When kids are listening to us, we are the first contact to popular music, right? Mm. And how do I feel when I have to tell the kids, you want to check out Rain? You pay $500, ask your mom. How uncool is that, you know? Yeah. I don't think they kind of factor that in when they take their concerts out.
No, they don't. But Rain has, like, you know, the moms are probably fans as well. So, okay, come, I'll bring you there.
Okay.
For $500
to see water just come on down on him. On his,
Is that the famous bit about you want to see that? Pokan put together this clip.
Oh, Masa.
Australian pop diva Kylie Minogue has kicked off her Asian tour in Singapore. It may be a pleasure to get up close and personal with her, but that will probably burn a hole in your wallet, as the top-tier concert tickets call for $550. This is to date one of the most expensive concerts here, just second to legendary rock band The Police, which commands $600. Its lead singer Sting will return in December and go classical with songs from The Labyrinth. Again, the best it will cost you $600. Other expensive Western acts include Italian tenor Andrea Bocelli, The Rolling Stones, Eagles,
Welcome to the Hotel California,
and I'll say yes, you look wonderful,
Eric Clapton, and Christina Aguilera. But while concert-goers are paying more these days, they are not always guaranteed more satisfactory experiences. For one, Rihanna's 60-minute, error-laden gig has sparked some dissent.
You know I live a John life.
Diana Krall's concert was also slammed for its poor venue, where fans were forced to bear with the muddy feel, humid air, and noise from the F1 qualifying races. In comparison, Asian gigs seem to offer more value for money. Today's biggest Mandopop acts, including Wang Lihong, Jay Cho, and Stephanie Sun, command less than $200 for their priceless tickets, even though their concerts typically last for 2 hours or longer. But there are exceptions. Hong Kong's Jackie Chan used to command $300 in his heyday, while Malaysian R&B singer Anwar Zain's costliest ticket was sold at $250. But topping the charts is still Bollywood hunk Shah Rukh Khan, followed by K-pop icon Rain. So who has a say on how much you should fork out for a concert? And what's taken into consideration when tickets are priced? And would you pay more for this? This? Or this?
See, is that worth $500?
Well, the nipples.
He doesn't have a shirt on for the whole entire
just for that one segment, to have that water poured on him.
But he's not an ugly man for sure.
Yeah. But can he sing live?
He's okay. He was okay. Yeah. We think you've seen like both Western concerts and Asian concerts, right? Like, you know, Western tend to cost more. Do you think there's a difference actually?
I think the Asians seem to work harder for the money. I think it's in our blood.
Yeah, I agree.
Like, okay, like bringing back Anita Mui. For me, Anita Mui is like the queen of concerts. Mm. You know, she's always fabulous. Mm. Her concerts are like 3 hours type of, you know. Because once I went to see a concert.
In Hong Kong?
In Singapore. So it was like a club. Mm. And then she was supposed to sing for like 90 minutes. Mm-hmm. So she did. So the people was like, okay, you can see Cantonese, right? So after she came out, she's happy.
What's that mean?
Cantonese. So of course she high, she come out, she like happy, she sang. And then it ended like, it started maybe about like 8, it didn't end to about nearly 1.
Huh?
Seriously, it was a long time ago, like chameleon.
And became, wow.
It became like, but whoever, I didn't pay lah, of course, because you know. But whoever paid for it, I mean, come on, like, you earn lah.
I agree with Vitek. I think, you know, when I cover Bollywood concerts, right? Mm-hmm. These guys don't sing, mm-hmm. right? They can't sing. The actors can't sing. Shah Rukh Khan, you know, you mentioned his concert tickets were $500.
$500,
they're lip-syncing to songs sung by
other
proper singers, right? Singers with fabulous voices. Mm. But they really give you value for money. Mm-hmm. That the 2003 concert, when Shah Rukh was in Singapore, he got wheeled into the Singapore Indoor Stadium. He was on this tower, and the costumes were fabulous, the choreography was fabulous. Mm. Went on for 3 hours, 2.5 hours, 3 hours. Mm. Really worked the crowd. The crowd was in a frenzy. Mm. I mean, you don't see that with a Western concert, you know? I mean, you don't see people going into
a concert. Was there one, like, you know, Bollywood or Malay concert that you felt wasn't worth the money?
I didn't go to the Anwar Zain concert, but I know that his concert was $250. Mm. I thought that $250 was a little bit much. I mean, he's a ballad singer. That's his strength, basically. Mm. And I don't know if it was worth that much of money. Siti Nurhaliza's concert, on the other hand, was like $300 at the Esplanade earlier this year. Mm. But Siti Nurhaliza has a long repertoire, just as Anwar Zain. But, you know, she's got a really hardcore fan base.
Yeah.
Hardcore. You know, who would pay a lot of money.
How about Anita Sarawak? Have you seen her before?
Oh, yeah.
How's she like? Is she okay?
She's fabulous. She's so Las Vegas.
She sings Malay song like Sayang Cinta
Awak. She's like
Las Vegas style.
Very Las Vegas style.
Yeah, but does she charge a lot for her tickets?
Or no, I don't think so.
Imported from Las Vegas.
Speaking of Asian concerts.
Wait,
what joke?
I would pay money for Sheila Majid. That's it. That's all I want to say.
Speaking of Asian concerts, I spoke to Leslie Ong, director from Unusual Productions, to ask him, like, you know, how concert prices are actually decided. They've organized, you know, for Rain, Jay Cho, Ame, Sammy Cheng, and the upcoming Andy Lau. In this email, he said, okay, there are two factors that decide concert ticket prices: production value and cost of the concert, including crew, props, audio-visual equipment, and the artist's market value and fee. For an A-list Asian artists, the production cost, which is about half of the entire budget, is about $400,000 to $500,000. Artist fee varies, and the rest goes to, like, you know, rental of the venue, marketing promotions, licensing fees, airfare, hotel, transport, and others. So for a concert like that, the ticket price would be about $70,000 to $150,000. Okay, Rain commanded as high as $488 for his January 2007 concert because his production cost alone was more than $1 million. He had a big entourage and his stage equipment was flown here in containers from Korea, which added up to more cost. And then given the limited 8,000 seating capacity of the Singapore Indoor Stadium, ticket prices would increase significantly if production cost goes up so that the concert organizer can break even. Okay, you know, taking all this into consideration, do you all think it's still justified that, like, you know, let's say Kylie were to command $550,000?
It's a case of you pay for what you get. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you really, it's again back to supply and demand. So if you really, 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 really love Rain, and you just die must see, and the DVD of concert cannot satisfy you, then you pay.
Yeah, I mean, it's the same with the Asian concerts as well. I mean, Shah Rukh Khan is such a huge global star.
Yeah.
You want to see him live. And he is, he gives you value for money. I mean, in his concerts in the US and in the UK, they cost like in the thousands, you know, with the exchange
rate. So 500 here is like, okay, reasonable.
It's a bargain compared to the concert, the amount he charges in the UK and in the US.
I think it's just a rip-off, you know. Because can you imagine if Rain said, oh, you just pay $88? Everyone would think, ooh, it must suck, right? So I think it's just this trend, right? They just say, oh, it's $400, it's $500.
So you think that,
and everyone's thinking
value,
like, oh, this is my experience. It's going to be my experience. If you pay $500 and you have to save 2 months to go watch this $500 concert, you're going to make sure you enjoy it.
Yeah, even if it sucked, you have to tell people.
Exactly.
You know,
you can't, who will pay $500 and come back and just say, like, I didn't like it? Only the people who got it free. Then they can be objective and go like, it's okay.
Yeah,
or if you're
yeah.
super rich, lah.
Exactly, exactly. So I think there's this, I mean, yes, you give us all the details, you tell us the cost, and that's the reason why the prices are so high, but is that our problem? We want to see you sing well and give us what we believed in when you first came up with that hit song. I mean, the costumes and stuff, okay, those are nice, the frills and the peripherals, that's great and stuff like that. But if you can't give us a good concert, please don't try to overmarket yourself and say like, hey, this $500 ticket is going to definitely give you an experience.
But I think having said that, like we take brought up, you know, the current economic situation, whether it's viable to pay for such expensive tickets. I mean, personally, I feel the whole stadium era style concerts, I think it's over. Because, you know, it's...
So people should move out to, I think, more to like Fort Canning or even...
Some, yeah, very specific niche locations probably.
Actually, if it's $550 and if it's like the Esplanade and it's like maybe 80 people and it's so intimate, I might consider paying for that because it is going to be really a very special experience.
Yes.
You know, like, it's just, it's like literally like you're sitting at the feet of the performer, maybe. But of course, some people like the experience of like a party, so everybody wants to be,
but
so you have a common experience.
But what kind of a party is it if you're sitting down?
Exactly.
Yeah, and back to Kylie, it was a dancing party.
Okay, personally, what's the most you've ever paid for a concert? Or like the best seats you've had?
I've paid, but it was a long time ago, considering my age. I think it was it's about
$80.
$200 plus for front row for Diana Ross.
Oh, wow. Endless Love. Did she sing Endless Love?
I think she did. She sang everything. She had every song.
And a gazillion costume changes.
That one.
Round and round you turn me.
Back then, it was a lot of money.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And, but it was very...
When you were a student.
No, I'm not a student. I'm not that young.
Just say yes.
Yes.
Secondary school.
I was a toddler.
Yeah,
student
man say for 1 year.
So it was like $200 plus, nearly $300 or something, front row. And it was... It was very painful at first, but after the concert, it felt like, wow, it was worth every cent I paid because it was amazing. It was one of the most amazing concerts I've been to, and it's like etched in my mind forever and ever and ever.
Sheila?
I paid close to $200, and I'm sure going to show my age at this stage, for Bon Jovi.
Oh,
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 oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
You give her a bad name. Like a link.
Now my turn to give the deep. So I can take a breath. But this was after the bad hair days. Okay, come on. I justified.
It was
really worth it. I was there with, I was a student then. Thank you, Suzanne.
Thank you.
I was a student then. I went with all my classmates. And, you know, we all scrimped and saved for it. And we were, they took the seats away and we all were standing and we're dancing. And it was just a really huge party for us. And we had such a great time. Yeah, and you know, that was worth it. I'm sorry,
And
we will laugh too. No, this I didn't pay, but it was a free seat, and I went because it was the Rolling Stones, and I had the fourth seat from the stage. I mean, the fourth row. I was on the fourth row, so I was so close to Mick Jagger and Keith Richards. And when I first saw them come on stage, I was like, I hope they don't die, bloody hell. I've been witnessing a heart attack right in my face. And they were like,
and considering all the supported the pharmaceutical industry for a long time.
I was like, these people are so old, you know. And the guy I was with went, I don't want anybody to stand up. They'll block my view. I paid a lot of money for these tickets, you know. I just thought, there you go, off to a roaring start, this Rolling Stone concert. And talk about rockers, right? But they were so good. Even though I didn't know the song, I only knew Satisfaction and Brown Sugar. I think after the fourth song, Mick Jagger, I mean, his sweat fell on me. That guy, he is thin because he works out. It was 2.5 hours. And at the end, after the first half hour, you forget that they all passed 60.
I just want to ask you, did you wash your neck after that?
No. I think the sweat. And he comes so close and he really does the eye contact. Like in the video, it was amazing.
I'm sorry, I've got to interrupt.
Okay.
Well, we let our viewers, you know, think about their most memorable concert experience. We'll be back.
Still coming back.